my lecture. Here in this lecture, I have selected one question from your said chapter. The question is this one. If the set A contains 17 odd numbers are there, and the set B contains only even numbers 2, 4, 6, even nested number actually 2, 4, 6 up to 18. And this one, bold letter N, is the set of nested numbers, and it will behave just like the universal set here in this case. Already we have explained it because we have got it. For depending upon the set, universal set will be defined. Okay, depending upon the set, universal set will be defined. So here in this one question, the set of nested number will behave just like a universal set. Then we have to show that the value of this expression is equal to the nested number set. A complement union of A union B intersection B complement is equal to the universal set. So we have the idea of one specific planar, you know. So let's recall it. Let A be the set here, and then obviously the all those elements which are there not in A is known as elements of the A complement. And then it will be known as the universal set. But here, what is the name of the universal set? The nested number set is the universal set. Then obviously we can see with the conclusion that the elements of A and A complement, A union A complement is equal to the universal set. Correct? Here the universal set is the nested number. And at intersection, A intersection A complement is equal to 5. So we can easily identify these two formula and we have to apply. So, solution is this one. So, let's start. So, A is the set given it is A is equal to what? 1, 3, 5 up to 17. And B is the set which contains 2, 4, 6 up to 18. Only here in case of the set A, all nested numbers are there. In the set B, even nested numbers are there. Then they are intersection. A intersection B is equal to 5. No elements are there. And okay, so now we consider left hand side and we try to show that this left hand side is equal to right hand side. The below this one expression is equal to the universal set here. So we have got an A intersection B is equal to 5. We will use it here. A intersection B is equal to 5. Equation number suppose 1. So now, so left hand side we will consider A complement union. A union B intersection B complement. Try to simplify. So listen, A complement union. Here, first of all, we will try to simplify the expression which lies inside the curly bracket. So as the operation lies inside the bracket, as well as the outside the bracket are defined. So we will try to apply the distributive property. So what is the distributive property? First of all, we will have the operation between A intersection B complement, then union B intersection B complement. Okay? So which property we have used here? Write down distributive property. Okay? The next step, what it will do? It will be A complement union. So B intersection B complement. We know that the intersection of a set and its complement is always equal to what? Is always equal to 5. So that's why we have got A intersection B complement union 5. So this one is a non-empty set and this one is an empty set. So empty set or our G set or union of what I like. The non-empty set will be meaning set. The elements of the non-empty set will be just like the result. So we keep going. A complement union, it will be what? A intersection B. Again, we have an expression whenever operation lies inside a bracket as well as the outside a bracket are different. So we'll have the distributive property here once again. So according to distributive property, it will be first of all we'll apply this operation between this intersection and complement intersection, a complement union, B complement. Again, we have applied the distributive property. Okay, so now we can simplify all those. So what do we do now? What is the below? Listen, a set and its complement, union of a set and its complement is always equal to what? Universal set. What is the universal set here? Actually, this is nothing but a universal set, but here in case universal set is nested number. So in case of this one, we write the nested number. Intersection. And this expression can be written as A intersection B whole complement. Am I correct? De Morgan's law.
Which property you can apply here?
De Morgan's law. De Morgan's law means what? De Morgan's. De Morgan's law.
De Morgan's law means what? According to this one, A complement union B complement is equal to A intersection B whole complement. Or you can say that A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement intersection will convert into union B complement. So again we have A intersection B is equal to 5. So intersection it will be 5 complement. Okay, so 5, what is the 5 complement? 5 complement is always equal to U intersection. We know that A complement is equal to U minus A. It is known to you. Therefore, 5 complement means what? U minus 1. How many elements you have to subtract from the universal set? Not a single element you have to subtract. It is whatever maybe the elements are there. Initially, in the universal set, all those elements will remain same. And again, my opera. 5 opera 0 minus 1 element is 5. 100 opera 0 minus 1 element is 100. Just like the subtraction of the empty set from a non-empty set. Non-empty set will remain same. So that's why here it will be, that's why 5 complement is equal to what? U. But here, what is the hello of the universal set? What is the universal set natural number? We know that A intersection A is equal to A, and then A union A is also equal to A. So that's why A intersection A is equal to A. This we have got the right side. I hope you have got my point. Here also we have considered some properties which are very important for us. Just like as 5 complement is equal to U, U complement is equal to 5, A intersection A complement is equal to 5, A union A complement is equal to the universal set. Here we have written natural number because here in this question, natural number set is because just like the universal set. So I hope you have got my point. Thank you so much for watching the video.